Alright guys, I'm working on a couple new mod deals, little cheap, stuff. I'm looking for some small little sponsor things here and there. So I do have some stuff in the works that I hopefully will get to bring you soon, some more cool mod videos. I just made a trip to the dump. I had this whole thing this high with bubble wrap and everything. I had to bring it to the dump. I'm probably going to break all this. I've given up trying to sell these TV boxes and wardrobe boxes for $5 a piece. I mean, I paid $20 to $25 a piece, but whatever. I'm going to break them all down. I want them out of here, take them to the dump, whatever, I don't care. Then I can finally have my car spot again. There's one thing I want to look at in the car right now, though, which is why I made this video. I've probably 1,000 times now, I push in the clutch, and it's not enough to get the car started. Turn off the ignition, turn it on again, push hard, keep it real seated. Half the time, more than half the time, it doesn't work. I mean, I'm not being lazy, I'm not pushing halfway, it's all the way down. I need to adjust that clutch switch a hair so I never have to deal with this again. It's every single time I start the car, I miss it, and I gotta turn it off and then press extra hard, and it shouldn't be that way. It should just be a normal switch. So I'm gonna go investigate down here underneath the car. Let's see what we got. Real quick, by the way, I did decide to stay with this mount, the Skosh. That's in my car now. It's on the outside vent. Let me show you, just for viewing. That's where I like it. Now, I looked at a lot, everybody talked about CD mounts, mini triangle side window mounts, windshield mounts, everything. I thought about all that, even ordered a few and then canceled the orders when I just said, wait a minute, this isn't what I want. I want this. It's the most simple design. It's not going to cover all the vents. The vent is halfway open. If it bothers you to have heat on the phone, you can close the vent. No big deal. That's the cleanest setup. This is the cleanest setup that I think I've seen out of every single one. Because it's so simple. It's just one little piece. I don't want a big old arm, a suction cup, all kinds of stuff visible. This is basically invisible when the phone's not on it. It just blends in with the vent. So I'll put another link to this one here. This is honestly my final choice. I have another one of these ordered now for her car. Just nice and simple, whatever. I don't expect it to mess with the nav, especially on the left side. Some people say it does, some people say it doesn't. I guess I'll be finding out. But the thing is, I don't use the Subaru nav. Maybe they meant the phone nav itself, but I just use the nav right now on that mount, no problems whatsoever. So let me get to the clutch issue. All right, I moved everything over because I want to just enjoy this spot for a minute. Parents gave me a piece of scrap carpet, which is pretty cool. Pretty good carpet. And just for scrap, I mean, mainly for lying on my back. I'm used to, at the old place, remember, I'd lay on cement and all my bones all stick out. I'm so skinny. And all my bones would be bruised every time I did a downpipe job. So this is a nice pad here. This could be really cool. My car doesn't leak anyway, but I wouldn't care if it dropped. This is just a piece of junk carpet, basically. So let me pull in the car here. All right, let me just do a measurement. I mean, 48. The car may fit this car. I don't know if the Forester is 6 inches longer. But obviously I'm not gonna do it. My toolbox needs to stay there. I love the setup. And I can pull in, you know, for jobs out of the wind and the rain. I think it's perfect. Let me check 48 inches in the back here. Be right back. Well, it would clear with like 1 to 2 inches, I think. I think it's a couple inches shorter than the Forester. Someone will look that up for me, please. And just tell me the lengths. I mean, I got so much to do today. So this one would technically fit. I sure as hell ain't gonna put it in here with 1 inch to spare, screw up all my nice design, and I can't walk around it. I don't care. I mean, the car is just wrecked with like yellow drippings and everything. I have to change my outlook after I moved here. The car is just always dirty and stuff, and it doesn't bother me. Screw it. I mean, I hardly ever clean it. Once a week or two, I might have a little treat to clean it, but there's no point. It's just going to be dirty the next day. But that doesn't mean I want to just abuse the paint and never clean it. And I do want to wax it, even though it seems like it's useless. So I will be still taking care of it, but I'm just not going to be polishing every bug off it every day like I used to, you know. You just don't do that unless you're in California. Those yellow sap stains from the damn trees and everything. And I'm not going to do a cover on it. People have mentioned, or my own parents have mentioned that. I don't want to be one of those douches, the only douche on the street that covers his car every night and uncovers it like a scumbag. That'd be typical Californian. So I'm not going to do that either. This is just the mellow life. Who cares, you know? It's awesome. All right, I'm finally going to get to that clutch. I'm trying to get there. What do we got here? Now, there's only one thing that can be that clutch switch, and it's right there. Of course, I don't know. See, this doesn't make sense because I have to push the clutch all the way down. That has nothing to do with the switch up here. And I know some of you guys know what's going on and what the hell I'm seeing here. There's a pad here. There's a pad at the back, but that has nothing to do with the electronic switch. You know, now I'm a little confused because I would only have to go halfway to get that pin disengaged, but the car won't start unless you go fully. And I don't see any other switches there. So what the hell is causing that? Oh, there's another switch above it. You can't barely see it, it's black. Let me get an adjustment. Let's see. There's another switch up there, and that would be the start switch. And that does also have an adjustment nut. Man, this is gonna be kind of tricky. All right, I'll figure it out. So it's gonna be hard to reach, but I'm gonna do it because it's gonna be worth it in the end. So the black switch above this blue switch is the one that controls the start sequence, and it is hard to get to. Okay, here's a better view. The bottom switch is for this blue one and probably some rollback thing, but the top one up there that is black and hard to see, the second connector on the left-ish side here, goes up to that one. Let's see if I can hold, I just need the light to stay. I can point out, it's so hard to see. My fingers on it, right here, is the connector. And this is the top connector. And this is the one, all I'm gonna do is adjust the nut, which I can give you a sample of the other one, same deal. You're gonna adjust the nut on each side and adjust the push pin so it'll start a little bit easier. But I just can't get a good light up there. I'm just trying to give you the best idea possible. Well, you can probably see back here, maybe behind that plate. I don't know what you can see. I'm gonna find out later. But there should be a nut on the back of this plate, like right in the camera right now, somewhere right around there, and the front nut, which was right there. See? That's it. Perfect. This is the nut I'm gonna adjust, and I just got to figure out which way to adjust it. I'm probably going to push the stud into that bracket, as in holding the harness side and pushing it further into the bracket so that, no, that's the wrong way, because you don't want to have to push your clutch quite as far in. No, that's right. Yeah. You're pushing the harness further into this plate bracket. Which will make it the plunger go deeper toward the firewall. Thus, you won't have to push the clutch in. I may be going in circles here, guys. I have to do it to fully get it. So I'll get back to you. Maybe I'm still backwards, but I'll find out as soon as I do it. I'm gonna figure out which way it has to go. Okay, I was right. So see, I push in and you gotta push all the way down. Meaning this is coming up like this and pushing that sensor in, and you gotta really get that good arc, that good swivel to push the switch all the way in to get it to do it. So what I'm gonna do is move that switch forward a little bit so you don't have to push your clutch quite, slam it into the carpet and crush your foot to activate that start switch. That's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna basically back out, lefty loosen the two nuts to bring that. First, I'm going to loosen the lock nut in the back. You do that one first on the firewall side.
loosen that all the way up. That's just like to hold it in place. Then this front nut toward the driver's seat is the one that's the adjustment. I'll back it up a little bit, which will in turn push the plunger a little bit deeper. Then I'll lock the nut in the back and we should be done.
Okay, so the next thing is you're gonna need two wrenches. When I'm trying to loosen the back one toward the firewall, the whole thing is spinning, including the front one. So you gotta anchor the front one in place, then crack the back one loose, all right?
All right, now you probably still can't see, but I can show you the idea here. This one is loose now because of the back nut. The firewall side nut, I backed up two or three turns. Now I'm gonna tighten this front one. No, it's a backwards now, okay. All I need to do is get the plunger toward the firewall. So I'm gonna figure that out. Let's see, tightening it, that's not gonna do it. That's gonna pull it away from the firewall. So I'm going to loosen, lefty loosen, this driver side nut, which will push the plunger deeper into that bracket. And that's exactly what I need there.
So I don't know if you guys can see the plunger up there, but what I did was, get rid of my shaking hand. So the plunger now pokes further through that hole. So when you push your clutch in on the lever, it's going to take less clutch travel to activate that switch and let you start the car. So now that I have the front nut on the driver's side of the bracket adjusted tight, I'm gonna cinch up the back one to lock everything in place. And I am gonna hold the front nut at the same time, like before.
That is a job that hurts your back, man, on this hard thing.
Okay, that's all done. I will update you in a follow-up in the next video or two and let you know if it worked or not. Now don't go too far in your adjustment, because of course you don't wanna have it so far that that plunger passes the point where it hits a dead end and breaks it or something. So you're really just going 2 or 3 millimeter in your adjustment if you have this issue where just half the time you don't push the clutch deep enough to start the car. I did about only 2 turns backed out on the rear nut, then the front nut, I backed out, I think that's what I said, the driver's side nut, I backed out. And turning it out is the same as pushing the other tube in, getting it further in so it takes less activation from the clutch to push it in. So everything's super tight. I hope this solves an issue I've had for 2 years. I've thought about this fix for months. I just never have the time. And I thought this is a good time because I just had that issue a few times today already. So yeah, adjusting your clutch so it's easier to start your car. All right, guys, that's it for now. Actually, that's almost it. Let me go ahead and I can test it. Why the hell not? Gotta move my seat back up. You move your seat forward, I mean back, when you're working under here, right? All right. Okay. Let's try it. Yeah. I think that did it. That looks good. I mean, most of the clutches have this squeak. Let me turn off this sound. But that's not a switch. That's nothing to do with the switch I adjusted. It's always done that. So it looks like it was successful. I didn't have to push with all my might onto the floor to get that switch to activate. So looks like it was successful.